Hello everyone, welcome to PharmaPill. Friends, have you ever tried to differentiate between the USFDA and MHRA OOS guideline? Currently, USFDA and MHRA guidelines are the only guidelines available for the OOS investigations. So in today's video, we will learn that what are the differences between USFDA and MHRA OOS guideline. And finally, I will tell you that which guideline is better according to me. So without any further delay, let's get started. Friends, existing USFDA guideline was published in October 2006, whereas MHRA guideline was published in August 2013. So from these dates, one thing is clear that the USFDA guideline was published 7 years earlier than the MHRA guideline. And one more important point you can note down here is that MHRA guideline was last updated in Feb 2018. USFDA guideline divides OOS investigation into two phases. Those are phase 1 and the phase 2. However, MHRA guideline divides OOS investigation into three phases. Those are phase 1, phase 2, and phase 3. In USFDA OOS guideline, there is no further subdivision of the phase 1 investigation. However, in MHRA OOS guideline, phase 1 has been further divided into two phases. Those are phase 1A and phase 1B. USFDA guideline talks about OOS and outlier results investigation. However, MHRA guideline talks about OOS, OOT, outlier results and atypical results investigation. USFDA guideline does not talk about the microbiological investigations. However, in MHRA guideline, you will find that the microbiological investigations are precisely elaborated. OOS and OOT investigations of the stability samples are not covered in the USFD guideline. However, in MHRA guideline, you will find that the stability samples OOS-OOT investigations are covered separately. USFD guideline does not talk about the 95% confidence limit concept while evaluating the mean value of the retesting results. However, as per MHRA guideline, 95% confidence limit should comply while considering the mean value of the retesting data. In USFDA OOS guideline, quality assurance term is not there. However, in MHRA guideline, you will find that the term quality assurance has been used throughout the guideline document. So guys, these were the 8 differences between the USFDA and MHRA OOS guideline. So from these differences, we can easily conclude that MHRA guideline is better than the USFDA guideline because MHRA guidelines has tried to cover all the points which are not there in the USFDA guideline, like microbiological investigations, stability sample, OOS, OOT, confidence limit concept, etc. Finally, I just want to mention one more important point which is given in the end of the MHRA guideline, which says that MHRA guideline is a complementary to USFDA guideline. It means if something which is not covered in the USFDA guideline, that can be referred from the MHRA guideline and vice versa. So with this note, I would like to wrap up my video. I hope you learned something new today, friends. Thank you very much for watching PharmaPill. Bye-bye and happy learning.